So recently, one of our YouTube viewers asked a very important question that all the terms visceral pericardium and epicardium refers to the same structure or whether they are two different closely adherent structures. Well, the short answer to this question is that they are not two different structures. The term visceral pericardium and the epicardium, it refers to the same structure. So essentially, the term visceral pericardium is equal to the term epicardium. It is just the synonymous terms. But here, the question arises, why have we named it epicardium? Why have we put a separate name? Rather than just calling it visceral pericardium, why we call it epicardium as well? Is it to confuse our dear medical students? Well, no, there is a reason for it, and we will talk about that reason in this small visual lecture. Hello, I'm Dr. Aizaz from MedicoVisual.com. Welcome to this visual lecture. So here, let's go back to the embryology of heart, embryology of pericardium, and here, let's suppose that we have the heart tube. So here we have this heart tube. This one is the heart tube, and heart tube is wrapped around, it is wrapped around from all sides by a layer, and this layer is called a layer of mesoderm, and this mesoderm is intra-embryonic splanchnopleuric mesoderm, and this layer, it then goes backward, I mean dorsally, and then it reflects around to form, to continue as the intra-embryonic somatopleuric mesoderm, which is going to form the parietal pericardium. So now at this time we can say that this layer which is wrapping around, I mean the intraembryonic splanchnopleuric mesoderm, this layer which is wrapping around the heart tube or primitive heart, this can be called as, well, it is not actually true, but let's write it visceral for the sake of concept. Let's call it visceral pericardium or visceral layer of pericardium. And of course, this somatopleuric, intraembryonic somatopleuric mesoderm is of course the parietal pericardium. And in between them, this cavity is called the pericardial cavity. Now, similar arrangement can be seen in case of other organs. For example, if we talk about stomach, the stomach is wrapped around by intraembryonic splanchnopleuric mesoderm, which will form the definitive visceral peritoneum. In case of stomach, it will form definitive visceral peritoneum, and it will then go back to form the mesentery of stomach, and ultimately it will be reflected around the body wall to form the parietal peritoneum. But here the story is different. This visceral pericardium, which I am right now calling visceral pericardium, it is not visceral pericardium actually. Of course, we can name it primitive visceral pericardium, but it is not definitive. It is not definitive. Pericardium. Definitive pericardium is formed through another process. Okay, let's just remove it. So what is the definitive pericardium? Actually, what happens with this layer, with this intraembryonic splanchnopleuric mesoderm, or what I am calling as primitive visceral pericardium, what actually happens to it is that it will be transformed to a layer which will form the myocardium. And some of its cell will proliferate to form an aggregate of cells here. Let me show you the animation. So it will be transformed into the myocardium, and some of the cell, they aggregated here, right? And even if some intraembryonic splanchnopleuric mesoderm remains, it will be destroyed. It will degenerate. And this aggregate of cell here, which actually came from the intraembryonic splanchnopleuric mesoderm, their mesenchymal cells, they proliferated and they migrated here and collected here and aggregated here to form this organ-like structure. This is not truly organ, I think. Now, this organ or organ-like structure, it will send its cells there. Its cells will migrate around this heart tube to form another layer outside the myocardium. Of course, there is the formation of cardiac jelly as well that we will not discuss today. But this organ-like structure, it will send the cells to form another layer outside the myocardium. And this layer is epicardium. This layer is the third layer of heart. This is the outermost layer of heart, and that is why we now call it epicardium, which is the outermost epicardium outside the heart, outermost layer of the heart. So this is the epicardium, which although derived from the intraembryonic splanchnopleuric mesoderm, but not directly, indirectly through this organ, which is by the way called pro-epicardial organ. Now this epicardium, it is actually the outermost layer of heart, but at the same time, its structure is much like the previously formed visceral pericardium, or its structure is similar to the structure of peritoneal membranes or pleural membranes or any other pericardial membrane. Actually, it consists of single flattened layer of cells. If I draw it somewhat here, so it consists of single flattened layer somewhat like this. These are called mesothelial cells. It is structurally similar to the visceral pericardium or visceral peritoneum or visceral pleura. It is structurally as well as functionally similar, but it is not embryologically exactly similar to the peritoneum, I mean visceral peritoneum or visceral pleura. It has indirect origin from the intraembryonic splanchnopleuric mesoderm. So it has given another name. This warrants another name that must be given to this layer. And this layer is actually acting as outermost layer, and that is why it is more appropriately called as epicardium. It is more appropriately called as epicardium, but because structurally and functionally it resembles the visceral pericardium or visceral peritoneum or whatever the similar layers are in our body, so we can also call it visceral pericardium. But its origin is not exactly like the other structures in our body. So that is why we call it epicardium as well as visceral pericardium. And of course, by the way, this diagram is not anatomically, this model, 3D model is not, of course, anatomically correct. Especially the space is humongous. It is not that much bigger space in the pericardial cavity. But this is just for the sake of the concept. Of course, outside that, there will be the fibrous pericardium as well. But this is the basic concept of today's lecture. I hope you understood it, and I hope you learned something from this video. If you have any question, please mention in the comments below. And by the way, if you are interested in understanding the embryology of cardiovascular system, or there are many different topics of embryology that are discussed on our website, medicovisual.com, please do check out the medicovisual.com, and you may be interested in buying one of our course on the embryology. Thank you so much for watching this video.